Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, my dear friends in Christ. We begin this Sunday reflection in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It's another day of worship, and we thank God for being alive in the land of the living. Thank you, Jesus. We continue to pray and ask God to return things to normal so that lovers of Christ can worship God in His sanctuary. Father, we pray that things will get better, that this coronavirus will go, so that your children will return back to church to praise and worship you. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today our topic is titled, Father, Glorify Your Son. And our Bible sharing is taken from the Gospel of Luke, John chapter 17. From verse 1 to 11. The Gospel of John, chapter 17, from 1 to 11. Father, glorify your Son. In this chapter of Gospel of John, our Lord Jesus Christ said many prayers, both for himself and the disciples. One of the prayers is that God the Father should glorify his Son. And I know you can ask this question, why should God glorify his Son? According to the passage, it is because the Son has already glorified the Father by obeying him, by doing the work, by obeying his Father. The Son has already obeyed the Father by doing what the Father has asked him to do. He did the work he was sent for and completed it. All of us are happy when we give people responsibilities and they do them very well and satisfactorily. Our Master satisfied God through obedience. He fulfilled the conditions to be glorified. Amen. So he prayed for it and God granted it. God's glory upon us is to respond to our obedience. God's glory upon us is a response to our obedience and a mark of his acceptance. God's glory makes our lives blessed. God's glory makes our life beautiful. I ask you now, do you want your life and your family to be blessed? Do you want your life and your family to be beautiful? Do you want your life and your family to radiate the glory of God? I'm sure your answer is yes. Then if you want that, you must do God's will. You must obey God's will. Just as Jesus Christ obeyed the Father. Do your part, and God will do his part. Children of God, hear me again. Do your part and God will do his own part. He does not fail. He will not fail and he will not fail you. Amen. Father, we yield our lives to you and pray today that you will glorify us as you glorified your only begotten Son. That the world may know that truly we are your children. That is our prayer today, O Lord, that you will glorify us, your children, just as you glorify your Son, Jesus Christ, so that the world may know that we are your children. If you pray this prayer, I want you to say amen. A big amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, because we know that our lives will not remain the same again. For you will glorify yourself in us. People will see us and know that the glory of God is in us. People will see us and know that the glory of God is radiating around us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Father, we thank you. We thank you for you have glorified yourself, and we pray, O Lord, that you will glorify yourself again in our lives. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Happy Sunday. Enjoy a fruitful one, a peaceful Sunday, and a fruitful week ahead. May this week be a peaceful week for us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. From over to you, Lord Women Prayer Group, we'll send your greetings and we'll continue to pray for all of us. God will see us through. In Jesus' name, amen. Stay blessed and stay safe. Thank you, Jesus.